Bye. unexpected boom made everyone go mad. One ran circles like a loon with a bucket round his head. But he fell in the lagoon and came out a deal more red and wetter than before, crying, "Mercy on my lord!" Still, he set his mind on filling sacks anew with baubles he could find. But he was seen by a non-Jew who struck him from behind and hit him hard and cruel to rob him of his hoard. And he sent him back to the Lord. Eclec ladies means in the heaven as damn in all men house. And then come and put me in the word that I'm to pass. For him who is in the end and the road is past. And literal is a skin. She all of a man. Then come does that make a shame. And from these my thoughts and said. Hey, my book and read. And he cut it and hit it. And he took it and put it in.
Yeah.
thing the child remembered was looking down from a window and seeing, ever so far below, green water flowing, and on it, gondolas flying, and fishing boats with colored sails, the men in them looking as small as children. For he was born in the Ghetto di Venezia, on the seventh story of an ancient house. A dusky staircase, the gaunt, whitewashed walls, led down and down past doors whose lintels all wore little cases containing Hebrew words, into a narrow court. A few yards to the right was a portico leading to the bank of a canal, but a grim iron gate barred the way. The water of another canal came right up to the back of the ghetto and cut off all egress that way. And the other porticos leading to the outer world were likewise provided with gates guarded by Venetian watchmen. These gates were closed at midnight and opened in the morning, unless it was Shabbat or a Christian holiday, but they remained shut all day so that no Jew could go in or out of the court, street, the big and little square, and the one or two tiny alleys that made up the ghetto.
Ensemble Lucidarium.
great rabbi, Leo the Modern, writes, during the month of Kislev, 5375, my son, Mordechai, may his memory be a blessing, began studying the art of alchemy with a great master, the priest Giuseppe Grimm. He applied himself so diligently and became so adept at his practices that even the most esteemed and seasoned experts of the art were amazed at how someone so young could be so knowledgeable. During the month of Iyar, he set up entirely by his own hand a workshop in the Ghetto. His first experiment was one he had carried out at a priest's house many times, using 9 ounces of lead and 1 of silver. He was able to produce 10 ounces. I observed the actions and controlled the results. The process worked, even if it did call for a great deal of exertion and strain and a waiting period of 2.5 months. I was able to sell the final product for 6.5 lire dirhams, and according to our calculations, our earnings could reach upwards of 1,000 ducats a year. These were not big revenues. Having consumed much of my life in alchemic pursuits, I would have certainly detected any flaw in the results. And so, it would have been, if Mordecai, may his memory be a blessing, if Mordecai's mouth hadn't filled up with blood during the Sukkot celebrations of 5376. It was said that it was the vapors of arsenic and salt, both necessary for the production of silver, that somehow damaged his mind, forcing him to abandon such arts forever. And so it went on for 2 years with Mordechai, may his memory be a blessing, giving us alchemy altogether and limiting himself light activities until death did come.
Thank you.
My name is Giacomo. My father was known as Raffaello Francioso, and my mother is known as Stella. And at present, she is married to a medico. My father was a Jew, my mother is a Jew, and I myself was born a Jew. I was called Aaron at birth, but I have been baptized upon a few different occasions. It was on the Giorno dell'Assunta after lunch when I was baptized here in Venezia. I had as godfathers Ser Jacopo de Paternostri and El Frutarol, the greengrocer, who has his shop near the bridge of Canareggio. I was given the name Giacomo and 14 coins in purest charity. After that, it was a priest from Padova who begged me to convert to Christianity, and I really did consider being baptized. But then I left for Modena. And while I was there, I went to the vicario and I told him I was a Jew and I wanted to be baptized. And the vicario wrote me a letter and he sent me to the priest that keeps an eye on all the converted women in the city. And that priest accepted me and kept me with him for 1 month, full board. And I was taught all there was to know about the Christian faith. And one Sunday, after lunch, I was baptized in the Cathedrale di San Gimignano in Modena. I was given the name Paolo, but money is none of it. The third time was in Ravenna, some 4 months after the second. There was this Signor Grasso di Bologna dello Spirito Santo, to whom I said I was a Jew and I wanted to convert, and in whose house I spent 16 days, and then one more to work, at the end of which I was baptized and I was given the name Baptista. And when I left Ravenna, the Signor Grasso di Dio la Via Gloria gave me 2 golden scudi, I swear, in very purest charity. And the fourth time I was baptized was at the Badia, when I came on La Domenica de Passion, and I went to the Monastero di Santa Maria and told the priest that I was a Jew and I wanted to become a Christian. And he kept me there with him for 5 days, and he taught me all there is to know about the Christian faith. And then on the following Domenica delle Palme, after dinner, in said church, I was baptized by the vicario, and I was given the name Francisco. And nothing more at all, save for one set of clothes and 6 ducati, which were given to me in nothing but charity. And then I write here, my name is Aaron Giacomo Paolo Baptista Francesco. I am a Jew, but I really desire to convert to the true faith. Signore, signore, please, aiutate la mia povera anima.
Thank you.
Young lad goes out one dark night. He sails over the Rhine on a water lily petal to see his dearest part. When he gets to his love's door, he finds it shut, locked, across her down. Frozen through and through, he asks his love to let him in. She says that she will not open until he promises to be true to her alone forever. And
Was it
boss would say, "Well, darling, of course, I will be yours until the end of time." But the boy, I don't know, maybe it was for the cold, for the exhaustion, maybe he was just laying down. And he said, "Well, you know, I'd like to make love to you now, but marrying, you know, I'm not the marrying kind." His love had actually two sisters, and the youngest one, not yet 13, but clever beyond her years to go with. She let the lad in, she brought him upstairs, and she showed him her bed.
Here at the museum, Samantha Hirsch and Bonnie Unger and all of the staff, the lighting people, because they did a really fantastic job. Thank you very much. Thank you.